Hey everyone, this is Dr. Drizzle, and today we are in Ringing Rocks County Park in Upper Black Eddy, Pennsylvania. The reason for that is each of these rocks has a special sound. As you can see, these rocks make music, and today we're going to talk about music and the sounds that we hear in nature and the sounds that we can create on our own, and I have a special challenge for you.
So this looks like a great place for a rock concert, and indeed it was. In 1890, J.J. Ott played here for the local historical society. He used rocks procured from this boulder area, 7 acres of rocks with over 10 feet of boulders. Only about a third of these rocks actually ring, and for a long time we didn't even know why. But in 1965, a group of scientists came here and they crushed open the rocks, sliced them open, and they found out that while all of the rocks do in fact ring, they often do so at tones that are lower than the human ear can perceive. Now you may want to take one of these rocks with you. Don't, because it's illegal. But actually they have found that the rocks away from their friends don't even ring. They need to be with the other rocks to ring.
You know, if I ever wanted to be a rock and roll drummer, this would be my chance. So in this challenge, we're gonna talk about sounds and how we can make sounds with unconventional items, like rocks. We may even find things around our house that we can use, but please don't use a hammer and make sure you ask permission. Right now, I'm going to work on my audition tape for Billy Joel's new tour. I heard the drummer's been there a long time, and he may need a little help. Thanks everyone, this is Dr. Drizzle, out.